Welcome back. In Minnesota, winter's some of the favorite for people, especially plow drivers and anyone who helps to clear the roads, parking lots, and driveways. For years, groups at Dunwoody College have been inventing ways to make that easier. We have a robot in the building, y'all. I'm telling you, it's really cool. It's already moving. We've got one of those groups in the studio right now. We have EJ Daigle, who runs the program, and we have students Ashley, Kit, and Liam joining us. Thank you all, my lovely smart people, that you're here with me today. Okay, so tell me a little bit more about the autonomous snowplow competition right here in Minneapolis.
Absolutely. So for the past 15 years, students from engineering and technology universities from across the upper Midwest and Canada, they come to the Twin Cities to compete at the autonomous snowplow competition and show off the latest in autonomous snowplow. Liam's driving it right now manually, but this vehicle is designed to track and navigate completely autonomous.
That's amazing. I know that there are plenty of people who have slipped and busted their behind outside who really appreciate the smarts that you all have put through this. So what all is involved in doing something like this? Obviously a ton of skill.
Go for it, Kit.
So we have three different plows at Dunwoody. They're all kind of trying to target a different technology or way of navigating. This one, like we said, uses that camera to track the fiducials. Ashley's robot, which is road salt, that one uses a GPS-based navigation. And then I'm on the team for the Snow Devil. That one uses, we have magnetic strips. The thought of that it would be embedded in your driveway, so it would follow a set path every time. And that way you can kind of have a nice preset route and you know it's going to apply your driveway.
That's amazing. And obviously you all create. Ashley, why is this so important to help get our technology up to speed? Because this seems like this would change people's lives.
Yeah, I mean, of course it'd be really nice for like have a snowplow not be able to use that, but I'm looking to go into the manufacturing field and they're always looking for new ways to have autonomous vehicles move in like warehouses and stuff. So it's really useful to go into that career.
Wonderful.
To have the knowledge.
And my man, you are over here driving this thing like a champ. First when you said you were gonna drive it, I was like, okay now, don't hit me. But you have been just over here driving it. What all goes into moving it around? And then what is this thing for?
So basically the camera that's on top of the robot there,
yes,
when it drives autonomously, it's gonna look for that shape and it's gonna try to align itself to get that in the middle of its camera screen.
Oh.
It's just gonna drive towards it until it gets close enough and then perform a turn and look for another one basically. So there's like a set path it'll follow.
I like it a lot. We've learned so much today. I know you have to be so proud. Obviously, this is a heck of a competition to be a part of. You hoping that this makes the future bright?
Oh, absolutely. Yes. It's going to be fun. On Saturday at Dunwoody College from 8 to 4, we're going to have about 10 teams from across the upper Midwest and Canada competing. It's a family fun event. It's a free event, so we hope people come out and watch because you're going to see some of the brightest future engineers and technicians.
Oh, we love it. You know what I say? If it's for free, it's for me and it's for you too. Thank you all for making us a little bit smarter. Thank you all for hanging out with us. And a quick shout out to my sorority, Alpha Kappa Alpha Sorority Incorporated. It's our Founders Day, 117 years of great service. You all be encouraged. We'll see you tomorrow.